So, is another topic. Binomial theorem and Pascal triangle. So, let's solve for binomial theorem. So, example one that binomial theorem is expand open bracket n plus 2 close bracket raised to power 5. So, how are we going to solve it? So, how are we going to solve? So, example one, solution. When you have open bracket n plus 2 raised to power what? 5. Do we understand? When we have 3 plus 2 close bracket raised to power 5, it's going to be what? You do it like this. We are going to use combinations, rules, and permutation to solve this question. So we are going to have 5 combination 0 open bracket 3 close bracket raised to power 5 then plus 2 raised to power 0. You can see, then let's move forward. Then we are going to have plus 5 combination 1, then 3 n raised to power what? 4, then 2 raised to power what? 1. There is something I want you to what? To understand. So if you are solving this, your what? Your 3 n will be what? Decreasing, while your what? Your 2 will be what? Increasing. So that's what we have here. So we are going to have 3n increasing. Then when you are moving forward, you can see your 3n is what? Decreasing. While your 2 is what? Increasing. So we are going to have plus 5 combination 2. We are going to have 3n close bracket raised to power 3. Then 2 raised to power what? 2. So the 2 is increasing while your 3n is also what? Decreasing. So we move forward. So we are going to have plus 5 combination 3, then 3 combination 3 raised to power what? 2 is decreasing. Then your 2 raised to power 3. Then plus again. Do you understand? So we are going to have our what? C5 4. Then we are going to have 3n. Then what? Our 1. Then we are going to have 2 raised to power what? 4. Plus. Do you understand? So we are moving to our final stage from here. We are going to have 5 combination 5. We are going to have 3 n raised to power 0. Then our 2 raised to power 5. That is step 1. Step 1, if you are using combination method to solve binomial theorem. So let's move on. So when you have, so let's solve our combination. This is our combination, the C. Anyway, you see C is our what? Combination. So let's solve for our what? Our combination in the what? In the quest, in the solving. Do we understand? So hope we can see it clearly. So okay. So we are going to have step 3, step 2, step Step two, we are going to have 5 factorial over what? 0 factorial over what? 5 minus 0 over factorial. Then we are going to have 3n close bracket. Then we repeat it. We repeat the same thing. We are going to have, or let's say 2 raised to power 0 is what? 1. To make it easier. Plus 5 factorial over 1 open bracket 5 minus 1 factorial. You open your bracket, you have your what, you repeat the same thing. Your 3n, then raised to power what? 4. Then 2 raised to power 1 is what? 2 times 2. Do you understand? Then plus again. You come here. You say 5 factorial over what? 5 factorial is going to be 2 open bracket 5 minus 2. Hope you can see it clearly. Factorial. Let me check. Maybe we can see it clearly.
Okay.
Can see it clearly like that. So let me clean it. So let me make it bold. So let's start from the beginning. We have 5 factorial 0 5 minus 0 factorial. Then you have what? 3n. Then raised to power what? 5. Then you have 1. 0 raised to power 2 is what? 1. Then you have plus again. Then you move to this place again. You are going to have 5 factorial over what? 1 open bracket 5 minus 1 factorial. Open bracket 3 and raised to power what? 4. Then you are going to have raised to 2. So 2 raised to power 1 is what? 2. So you are going to move on to the other side. So you are going to have 5 factorial over 2 open bracket 5 minus 2 factorial open bracket 3 and raised to power what? 3. No, raised to power 3, yes. Then 2 raised to power 2 is what? 4. 4. 2 times 2 is what? 4. So we are going to move on. We move on to this side. We are going to have 5 factorial over what? 3 open bracket 5 minus 3. We are going to have factorial open bracket 3n raised to power 2. 2 raised to power 3 is what? 8. Then we move on again. So, do we understand? We move on. So we are going to have 5 factorial. You are going to have 5 factorial over what? 4 factorial. Factorial, then 5 minus 4 close bracket factorial, then you are going to have 3 and raised to power 1, then 2 raised to power 4 is 16, then you are going to have 5 factorial will come to this place over what? 5 factorial, open bracket, 5 minus 5 factorial. So we are going to have 3n raised to power 0, then 2 raised to power 5 is what? 32. So, do we understand? So, here is going to be what? 1. Step 3. So, when you solve this, it's going to be 1. 1 times 3 n raised to the power 5 times 1 plus. Are we? So, we repeat the same thing here. This is going to be what? This is going to be 5 1 over what? 5 minus 1 is what? 4 factorial. 4 factorial, open bracket, 3 n raised to power 4, open bracket 2. Do you understand? Then the same thing here is going to be what? 5 factorial over 2 factorial. Then 5 minus 2 is what? 3 factorial, open bracket, 3 n raised to power 3, then open bracket 4. So do we understand? So we are going to have plus, again, we are going to have plus, we come to this place again. We come here, we'll solve for this. Then, we remain in this place, we are having 5 factorial, you have a 3 factorial, then 2 factorial, open bracket 3 n raised to power 2, then open bracket 8, then plus again, they have 5 factorial over 4 factorial, open bracket 5 minus 4 is what? 1 factorial, open bracket 3 n raised to power 1, then you are going to have 16. Do you understand? So we are going to have plus 5 factorial over 5 factorial is going to be what? 0 factorial. So we are going to have 3 n raised to power 0, then 32. So do we understand? Hope you can see it clearly.
Sorry. I think now it's better.
So let's move on. This is step 4. Our step 4 is going to be what? Our 3 raised to power 5 is going to be 2 4 3. Our 3 raised to power 5 is going to be what? 2 4 3. So I will have 2 2 4 3, then n raised to power 5, then plus, you understand? So we are going to have 5 times 4 factorial over 4 factorial, then 3 times 3, 9. 9 times 9 is 81. So we are going to have 81 n raised to power 4, then times 2, then plus again. We come to this side again, we solve. We are going to have 5 times 4 times 3 factorial over 2 factorial over 3 factorial. We are going to have 3 raised to the power 3 is 27 n cubed. Then close bracket, we are going to have 4, then plus. So we move on. We come to this place again. So we are going to have 5 factorial over 3 factorial. 5 times 4 times 3 factorial. We stop there. We are going to have 2 factorial. Then times 3 raised to the power 2 is 9 square. 9 square. Close bracket. Open bracket. 8. You understand? So you are going to have plus. Then we are going to have 5 times 4 factorial over. So we are going to have 5 times 4 factorial over 2. So do you understand? Then 9 times, what is it? Yeah. So we are going to have 4 factorial, open bracket, n raised to power 10 times 16. Do you understand? Then let's move this. So, hope we are seeing it.
Okay, very good.
It's clear? Very good. So now, let's continue. For this, you have plus 5 factorial over what? 5 factorial. Then this is going to change. 3 n raised to power 0 is what? 1. Then you are going to have 32. Do we understand? So step 3. Step 5. So you are going to have 2, 4, 3 raised to power 5 plus. This cancel this, it's going to give you 5. Then I'm going to have 81 n raised to power 4, then times 2 plus. Do you understand? So we are going to have this cancel this, this cancel this. We are going to have 2. So we are going to have 10. Times 27 n cubed times 4 plus, then this cancel this, this cancel this. We are going to have 2. 10 times 9 n cubed times 8, then plus again. 4 cancel 4. 4. 4 factorial equals to 4 factorial. I'm going to have 5 times 3n times 16. We are going to have plus again. 5 factorial equals to 5 factorial. So we are going to have 1 times 32. Do we understand? We are going to have 1 times 32. So let's move forward to step 6. Our step 6 is going to be step 6 20 will give you 40. 40 times 27 will give you 6. We give you 1080. We give you 1080. Raise to power what? Raise to power n q plus. So you move forward again. You are going to have 9 times 8. We give you 9 times 10. We give you 80. So 80 times 9, we give you 280 times 9, we give you 720. N squared plus this time is we give you 15. 15 times 16. 15 n times 16 we give you 240 n plus 32. Do we understand?
So I said 2 times 4 3 n raised to the power 5 plus 5 times 2 equals to 10 times 81 will give you 810 n raised to the power 4 plus 10 times 4 will give you 40. 40 times 27 n cubed will give you 1080 raised to the power 3 plus 10 times 8 will give you 80. 80 times n squared will give you 720 n squared plus 5 times 3 n will give you 15 n times 16 will give you 240 plus 32.
Am I correct? 240. Sorry. Am I correct? 5 times 3 will give you 15. Then when you now say 15 times 16 will give you okay, it's correct. We give you 240 n. So our final answer is this. This is our final answer in binomial theorem. Our final answer in binomial theorem is this. So I'll clean it, then we'll solve for number 2. We solve for question number 2. So this is the solving and the answer for question number 1. So I clean. So, question number 2 says, open bracket, x minus 3, close bracket, raised to power 4. This should not be long because the power here is raised to power 4. So, the first question says, n, the first question says 3n plus 2 raised to the power what?
5. Hope we are seeing it clearly. So,
let's continue. So we are going to solve. We're having four combinations, zero. We are going to have s raised to power 4, then minus 3 raised to power 0. We continue again. We have 4 combination 1. We are going to have s raised to power 3, then minus 3 raised to power 1. Then we continue again. Do you understand? So we're going to have c combination 4 combination 2, then s raised to power 3, then minus 3 raised to power 2. Then we'll move forward again. We have 4 combination 3. We have s raised to power 3. Sorry. We have 2 minus 3 raised to power 3. Our x is decreasing while our minus 3 is what? Increasing. So, we are going to have plus 4, we have plus 4 combination 4. No. We have them 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. How come? No. We have them 4. No, okay, this is where the mistake is. We're having 2. We should have 1. Our x is decreasing. So we're having 4 combination 4. Then s raised to power 0. Then minus 3 raised to power 4. So do we understand? Hope we can see clearly. Not clear enough.
So, so